Journaling can be an effective way to look inside of yourself and reflect and remember day-to-day moments. Notion can be a great tool for keeping your digital journal, and in this video, I wanted to share with you all a template tour of the updated Ultimate Digital Journal Notion template, including a brand new AI version. This template features tons of pre-made prompts, journal templates, and the AI version can allow you to chat with your very own journaling assistant. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's start with a brief overview of this template. So on the left-hand side, you'll see a navigation section where you'll have a mobile view of this digital journal so you can use it on the go. You'll find a page for prompt inspiration, and then it's primarily made up of journal notebooks here and journal entries. So how this template works is that you have various notebooks where you add journal entries to. These act mainly as categories, so you might have routine journals, hobby journal, health journal, and more. When you open one of these, you'll notice that you can see how many journal entries are inside, your last entry date, and you'll see your entries in table view, gallery view, and also in a calendar view, so you can see when you last journaled. In the bottom here for the journal entries, you'll see a table view list of all of your journal entries. You can add custom tags and notes, as well as choose to review them if you need to. If you open one of the entries, you'll notice that there's a prompts ideas here. So these are pulled up from the prompts database where you can have some inspiration on what you might want to write about. Inside here, you'll have your journal entry. The quick buttons here allow you to immediately add a daily entry, a weekly entry, monthly entry, and quarterly entry with just one click. For all other journal entries, you can easily add one through this new journal entry button here. And lastly, in this area here stores all of the databases, so I recommend not to delete any of the pages inside of here. Next, let's go over how to add a journal entry. So one of the first thing you'll want to do when you start using the Ultimate Digital Journal is simply to just start journaling. And to add a journal, you can click one of these buttons. So for example, if I want to add a daily entry, I can click here. You'll notice that it's already tagged by the daily journal. If I want to add additional tags here for different categories, I can do that, and it's going to show up in my journal notebooks. Then you can also add your own additional tags that aren't related to journals and notes here. And then here's where there's a lot of custom ways to journal. So we have daily entries, creative writing, movie reflections, and more. So you can just choose one of these, or if you just want a basic daily journal, you would click daily entry here. And when you open this up, you can check your prompt ideas for some ideas. What mindset or attitude do I want to cultivate today? How can I remind myself of this throughout the day? So you could just favorite this. In the favorites, you'll see the ones that you favorited. And for reflection, at the end of the day, you might want to do a reflection prompt. So you can also check here. And each of these sections are customized. So if you choose a different kind of journal entry, then you'll get a very different template inside. So I can just choose one of these and start journaling about it. And once I've done that one, then you'll notice that in the daily entries here, if I go here, you'll see the newest one that I've added inside of the entries table. You can also add a journal entry by clicking one of your journal notebooks. So let's say that I have a creative writing entry I want to add. I can click here, and it's already tagged by creative writing. And then I could choose the creative writing journal template here, and you can find some prompt ideas specifically for creative writing. Write a scene or story that includes a character fulfilling someone's dying wish, and so on. So there's quite a lot here to work with, and you can start journaling inside. If I click out, you'll notice that creative writing now has one journal entry. If you want to add one through this button here, so directly to the journal entries database, then you'll notice that journals have nothing inside of them. If I were to choose, for example, dream and sleep journal entry, then again, you see that the prompts are a little bit different. Because I didn't add a journal, so sometimes you might forget to add the journal category you want to add it to, you can go to the empty journal here and see that you need to fill this one in. So this is a sleep journal entry, so I'm just going to go look for sleep journal. Sleep and dreams here, and then it gets removed from my empty journal. One additional thing is that you can tag it for review, and then it's going to also show up here. So sometimes you might not finish writing what you wanted to write, so you can always tag that here to go back to it. Next, let's look more deeply into the journal notebook. So I've added a lot of different kinds of journal notebooks, but there could be some categories that are missing here that you want to add yourself. So just to give a brief overview, we have routine journal notebooks, things like daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly. We have hobby journal notebooks, so you can do reflections for books, music, photos, and so on. There's things for health, like your mood, your food, sleep and dreams, fitness. Then we have therapy section here, a productivity section. There's also a memory section here. And we have short forms if you want to do bullet journal or 5-minute journaling. And then there's also a place where you'll see journals that have no category. And then you can see a view all. So what we're going to do is, let's say that I want to add a journal notebook for my crafting hobby. So then I can click the new here, and then I'm going to call this one crafting. And if I go to the info tab, you'll see here that it's tagged by routine. I don't want it to be in routine. I want it to be inside of hobby. So I'm gonna change that to hobby. Now we basically have a crafting journal notebook, and I'm going to also add a cover photo. So I can go to Unsplash and let's look for something relating to knitting like this. And then if I click out, it should show up in my hobby journal section here. And if you check the filters here, you'll see that the tags are hobby. So whenever a notebook is tagged hobby, it's going to end up in this hobbies tab. If you go to view all, you can see all of the different tags. So whether that's hobby, health and hobby, and more. So you can create as many journal notebooks as you want. And just make sure to add the correct tag for the correct section. If a section doesn't exist, you can also create a new one by duplicating one of them. So if I do duplicate here, this would be a new tab. And you can add a custom tag here for whatever type of journal should end up in that tab. Next, let's go to the prompt inspiration section. So this is meant to be a page where you can keep track of all the prompts that you want to be inspired by to write each day about various topics. So you'll see your routine prompts, so daily prompts, weekly prompts, monthly, quarterly, and yearly. And these are shuffled, so you'll see different ones here when you open them. And then there's also hobby prompts. And there's also health prompts, therapy prompts, productivity prompts, memory prompts, and a view all section. So how this works is that, let's say that I want to favorite this one. So I really like this prompt. What mindset or attitude do I want to cultivate today? And if I now go back to my journal here, when I do a new daily entry, I'm going to see that in the favorite section. So I now start my daily journal. And in the prompt ideas, if I go now to favorites, I'm going to see what mindset or attitude do I want to cultivate today? What can I remind myself of this throughout the day? So whatever prompts that you favorite are going to show up in the relevant section. So if you, for example, favorite this one, you'll see it when you use the travel template. If you favorite this one, you'll see it in movie, reading, and music, for example. Just to reduce the complexity, these are not meant to be written into, so be sure to just ignore this bottom part and just focus on looking at this for inspiration and then doing the actual journaling inside of your journal entries here. The next thing I wanted to show is slightly more advanced customization. So we just added the hobby notebook for crafting. So let's say that you want to add a specific prompt for craft journaling. So if I go to my prompt inspiration and now I go to my hobby prompts, the first thing I'll need to do is to add a new section. So I'm going to actually just duplicate this one and call this one crafting. And what I'm going to do is to change the filter, and I'm going to remove this and then save. So now it's actually just showing everything. And the next thing I'm going to do is add a new prompt. So I'm going to go ahead and click new. And this one, let's say that, what are some crafting projects I'm working on right now? And then now if I go to the tag, I can add a new one called crafting like this, and then tag it with that. And then I can change the color to default like this. And then if I click out, now it has the tag crafting. So So what I can now do is if I'm in the hobby prompts crafting, I can now add that filter by going to the tag and then going to crafting. And then I can say for everyone. So now I see my crafting prompts here. The second step you'll want to do is if we go back, and now if I click the blue button here, and you can see all kinds of journal entry templates. The reading reflection, I can duplicate this one, and I'm going to call this crafting reflection. And then inside of the prompt ideas, I'm going to need to go to the filter, and instead of reading, I'm going to filter it by crafting. And then same in the favorites, I'm going to go to filter. Instead of reading, I'm going to filter it by crafting, like this. And now I have my prompts and my favorites, and you can see the prompt that we just added here. And I can delete this section here. You can even add other custom things inside of here you'd like to use as a template. And then if I click out, so now if I go to my crafting journal and click add entry, and then I choose the crafting reflection, I can go ahead and add that journal entry. And if I click the prompt ideas, you'll see the specific prompt I added for crafting here. So this is a bit more advanced. So if you're not as used to Notion, I would recommend doing this kind of customization later on once you're more comfortable with it. And now the final thing I wanted to showcase is the mobile view. So if you frequently want to journal on the go, then this mobile view can be really useful. It's just a simplified version of the same template. You can just click new journal entry to add a journal entry, and you'll see all of your journal entries in one convenient way here. And then you'll see all of your journals here in the various categories without the cover photo, so that it takes up less space. Now let's go over the Ultimate Digital Journal Plus AI version. Everything in this template is pretty much the same as the base version, but with the journal entries, you'll notice some key differences. So for example, there is this AI generated takeaway and advice that is generated based off of what you write inside of the journal entry. So for example, this journal is about a trip to Bali, and you can see the key takeaway and advice here: embrace the beauty of Bali by fully engaging with its nature. This is pretty cool that you can kind of extract various advice and takeaways based on what you've written yourself. You'll also see AI generated themes, so everyday presence, mindfulness, self-reflection, and these are automatically tagged. The biggest part of this template is the journaling assistant that's included. So if I click the journaling assistant here, this is basically an AI agent instructions page. And you can customize this as well. I've already filled it in, but when you download the template, this part is going to be all empty. So you can fill out your about me, you can fill out your interests in detail here, your experience with journaling, your goals with journaling. And this part I would recommend not to touch, because this is a key component of how this AI instructions page works, to make sure that it's only interacting with these specific databases. On the left hand side, the agent identity, you can also customize this part. So what kind of personality do you want your journaling assistant to be like, and who do you want them to be? So this journaling assistant is going to help me journal and maintain my journals and prompts and so on. So you can see that the personality and identity you can also customize yourself. And then in this section, it gets to know more about you outside of just the journal entries. And anything you suggest to it is going to go into the memory section here. So if I go back to my Ultimate Digital Journal Plus AI template, what you'll want to do is to click the icon here, and then you can click the personalize. And I've named this AI agent Journey, and you can choose various hats for your AI agent, and then click setup instructions, and then use existing page. And you'll want to look for this particular journaling assistant page. So if I click here now, then you'll see that there, and then I can click done. So to make sure that you've done this correctly, you can go to your journaling assistant, and this blue block should show up in the top like this to make sure that this is what it's using. So now what you can do with this journaling assistant is to have it surface old journal entries, or give you advice on how you should journal more, or have some prompts that they might suggest based on your interests. So I'm just going to type hello. And here you can see it's already telling me some prompts I could start with. And it can also surface a couple of past entries and so on. And another thing to note is that if you have this one on, it's going to be allowed to edit inside of the page. If it's off, then it cannot actually edit anything. And for journaling, I would recommend turning some of these off if you don't want external information going inside. So if you don't want web search, then you can turn that off and purely stick to your workspace. So let's say that I wanted to surface some information. So here you can see that it pulled up the sleep log that I recently wrote, and it's telling me some key takeaways and so on. So you can really chat with this, and the more you add to your journal entries database, the more the AI is going to have more to work with and really give you some interesting insights. Another way that you can use this is in the prompt inspiration. So you can basically add unlimited prompts here, and it's going to also tag it correctly. So let's say that I want some new prompts. It's going to add some new prompts in there for me. So now you can see added 12 new one sentence prompts to your prompt database across daily, weekly, mindfulness, self-reflection, goals, project mood, and sleep tags. It basically added a bunch, and you can see exactly what are the prompts that it's added as well. If you don't like that, you can also undo this action as well by clicking undo. So in general, I found that this AI agent has been a huge game changer for journaling and finding more about the different connections that you might not have noticed before, or surfacing very interesting journal entries that you've written in the past. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in the ultimate digital journal, be sure to check the links in the description for the base and the AI versions of the template. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.